In the spirit of Valentine's Day, which is this Saturday, folks, we bring you the love story of a longtime married local couple. Joe and Lovina Kerfoot have been married for 47 years, and although they've had their fair share of ups and downs, they've made it work.
We met in high school when we were going to Radford High School, and we graduated there in 65. However, I met this girl over there in 64 when we were juniors.
When I first saw Joe, he was dating a friend of mine, actually.
She had this charisma about her. She was always doing something. Well, she loved to dance. She was always dancing. When I finally got to really talk to her and everything, I knew she was the one that I wanted to be with, you know.
Wow.
Yeah, for sure.
After high school, it was pretty sure that we were gonna be together until we marry.
Then, in 66, almost a year after we had graduated, that's when I got drafted, got my draft notice.
So he came home on 30 days leave, and he was just in the military, not an officer or anything, so we didn't have a lot of money or anything, so got married at my sister's home, actually, and the judge lived up the street. Then Joe had to go off to Vietnam. When he was in Vietnam, we did a lot of letter writing.
Being away from her, I always look forward to the letter, a letter coming in. I made a sign with Kule, Lovina's middle name, and we put it on the front of our vehicle, and from then on, that vehicle was Kule.
Actually, when he came home, it was like getting to know each other all over again, and it just fell into place. We were married 5 years before we had our first child, and 7 years when we had our second child, and we had a boy and a girl, and it just time flew by after that. I think we're just meant for each other. I'm not saying our marriage is perfect, but every person in this whole wide world has good moments and bad moments. Joe doesn't argue, and it's really nerve-wracking, you know, because sometimes I really like a good fight. He'll talk, but not fight.
What I love about you is your honesty. Lovina has always been straightforward. If you what you see is what you get.
He's a good listener. If I had to say something to him, he would sit there and listen till he fell asleep.
Are you crying? I see watery eyes. I know you're with me. Lovina and Joe are here in studio with us this morning. Welcome.
Thank you.
What a nice story. You're seeing this for the first time this morning.
Yes.
What is your reaction to the story?
I didn't realize we did all that or said all that.
Yes. 47 years. That's a long time.
Yes.
Yeah.
It feels like it now.
After you kind of see the whole story, right? Mm-hmm. Going into the military and having children. I mean, 47 years, it is a long time. So what would you say, or what kind of tips do you have for others that are in a relationship?
Two things that I would say is two words, but and compromise. If you have a disagreement and you want to apologize, just say, Trini, I'm so sorry. Please accept my apology.
And do you guys do that?
Don't say the word but, because it's sometimes, Trini, I'm sorry. I want to apologize, but you really made me angry.
Ooh, don't ever do that with him.
Leave
don't
out the second part. The other
you
one
know
is
what? I actually, and I'm sorry to interrupt you, I went online because we were doing this Valentine's thing, and you know, there's a lot of websites that give tips on marriage. That is an excellent one that I did not find online. That is very, very insightful.
The other one is compromise, the word compromise. And I like that word because I hear people say, well, we agree to disagree. I don't think you can do that, because someone will walk away that disagreed, that it won't be complete. But if you go into a relationship and say, okay, we're going to compromise, then you really do, because you come out with a decision that both of you make.
Mm-hmm. I like that. Anything you want to add?
I have two things, respect and love. But respect comes with understanding each other. We both have our own opinion on things that happen. And I know how it is. I'm a strong, stern opinion of this thing. She has a totally opposite opinion. But we don't argue about it. We just respect each other's opinion. And from there, we try to work it out.
Now, do you walk away going, okay, I respect your opinion, but I know I'm right?
He doesn't say the word but anymore.
Oh, okay. No. I have to remember that. That's really hard to do. Stop saying the word but.
But that's where love comes in. Mm-hmm. You understand each other, and just for that sake, no, we're not going to get into this argument of going back and forth. Mm-hmm. If we love each other, we'll compromise, or respect is a thing.
Now, you said something to me during the interview that I want to share with our viewers, because it's also very helpful. When you guys do have disagreements, how do you handle it? I know this is live television, but tell us what he does.
He waits till I take a shower. Is that what you mean?
Yes.
Then he comes in because he says, family that bath together, stay together.
But it's true. I mean, I know it's funny, but a lot of people say never go to bed angry, or, you know, fight naked or something like that, because how can you stay mad with somebody that's, right?
I know. I mean, I can't get out because he's so big. I can't move.
Yes. No, I love that. I love that.
And he has one that he says.
Oh, my favorite saying is happy wife. Happy life.
Happy wife, happy life. We're going to end it there, because I've been telling my husband that for years. Happy wife, happy life. Thank you both so much for being with us this morning and sharing your story, because it's a beautiful story.
Thank you so much for having us.
Thank you.